Hi, Alicia DeSantis here with another episode of Branding Tips Tuesday. Today I wanted to talk about the recent shooting at the LGBTQA nightclub Q in Colorado Springs and how events like this allow your brand an opportunity to take a stand. A recent publication by Trustpilot, one of my favorite publications in the past few years, called Brands Who Take a Stand, outlines that studies they found from consumers that over 50% of consumers want the brands that they buy from to take a stand and talk about their stances on their website and social media and be transparent. The biggest causes that consumers want to see their brands take a stand on are human rights, animals, and the environment and ecosystem. So that being said, I'm met often with resistance for brands to take a stand with many of the brands I know of and do business with. There's a lot of fear in that the concept that if I post or make a statement about something that happened, for example, the shooting at Q, that it's going to isolate a group of my buyers or my consumers. And they're not going to be happy with me posting about that. But I would argue, who are your buyers who would be angry that you're posting about a shooting of innocent people? So it's something you have to ask yourself. Are those even buyers I want? Is that even a market segment I want? If there's that large of a segment of your audience and your target market that wouldn't want you to address something like that or would be angry with you, it's worth taking a hard look at who you're targeting. So one of the things I like to do with my clients is talk to them about a marketing risk scale, essentially. So on one end is the risk, one end is the reward. And where would an action, like openly, publicly taking a stand about something that has occurred, position you on that scale? Does the risk outweigh the reward? What's the reward? Well, there's a lot of them. Transparency, authenticity, showing the human side of your brand, showing that there's good people who care about others and care about the indignities that are happening in this country and in this world. Connecting with your audience more, the people who do care about that, these events, and instilling more trust in them that you as a company feel the way they do and support what they support. What are the risks? Isolating some of your audience and making them feel uncomfortable or feel like you don't have a place to say that and they no longer buy from you. Yes, that's always a possibility when you talk freely and candidly about controversial events. But again, that risk, I would argue, depending on the situation, is do you even want those types of people doing business with you? In a way, it can be beneficial because then it weeds out the people that you do business with that are unethical or bigoted or racist. So something to think about, again, while this is on all of our minds, hatred of LGBTQA community is fearful of taking a stance. Ask yourself really why and really assess that risk scale for your brand of what it means to stand by these people and what it means to your target audience. That's all for today. Take care.